Another travelogue. I'm sure you're thinking right now, another travelogue. I couldn't care less. Listen, I'm hoping that with the valuable things I'm going to share with you today that I feel are valuable, that you will care more about some of these tips. My story begins probably from when I was 4 years old, when my grandmother, Christina Obradovich, came to live with our family from Serbia. She stayed with us for the first 4 years of my life, the most informative. I learned to speak Serbian because she couldn't speak any English. And from that time on till she passed away in 2001, my communication with my grandmother was always in Serbian. And I thank her for that. Because of that, my ancestral home was someplace that I desired to visit my entire life. But it wasn't until a year ago, April, that my daughter Rochelle said, "Mom, before you die, I want to go to our ancestral home and visit Serbia and Croatia because I know you can help me better traverse the terrain because you speak the language." I said, "That's doable. Let's go for it." And sure enough, that's my first point. When you make a specific goal and you set it down, and we had a date, she wanted to go for her next birthday, the following April, we went. Our trip began April 25th. Her birthday was on the 28th of April. So we were there from the 25th, my travels began, until May 13th. So we were out traveling through Serbia and Croatia for 19 days. The first thing I want you to know about it was that as soon as I had definitively made the goal to go, miracles began to happen. I felt that a sixth sense was coming into play. I really felt my grandmother and my mother, who's passed away, I felt them around me, and miracles were happening. First of all, from that moment on, I met two friends, one Serbian, one Croatian, right here in Reno. And they helped me to plan the trip. So that was the first miracle. The second was our weather was projected to be a lot of rain, like Reno's been experiencing for the last little bit. And yet, miraculously also, it would be cloud covered and it would rain like torrential sometimes when we were traveling in a car or in a bus. But that didn't matter, did it? But as soon as we would get out in places, it would stop and I would see rainbows. I hardly ever see rainbows, but on this trip I was seeing rainbows and I was getting, you know, that sixth sense that only speaks to your heart and your mind that would say, "Don't worry, I've got your back." You know, that was my grandmother speaking to me. "This trip is going to be awesome. No worries." And it was like that. We set up, first of all, having a vehicle. We rented an automatic car, which I highly recommend. Most everyone uses stick shifts over there. But you are having some amazingly difficult roads to travel in. And a lot of narrowness, a lot of mountainous places in Serbia and Croatia, and so it was great to have the automatic car. We had idiosyncrasies from the three of us that were traveling. It ended up being myself, my daughter Rochelle, and my sister Christine, because she said, "If you guys are going to our ancestral home, I'm going with, like it or not." So she came. We all had our little things that would probably get on one another's nerves, but we also had our different strengths. I was the navigator and also the trip arranger and also the linguist. My sister was the driver. Most times she was driving us all crazy, but she was also the driver. And she was amazing, I have to say. I would never have had the courage to drive through some of the things that my sister drove through. Finally, my daughter, she was our social media expert. She kept us connected statewide, you know, to the United States, so everyone home could know where we were, what we were seeing, and that we were safe. So we all had our special little points to to provide for this trip. Then there was the adventure itself. We went to so many wonderful places. We started with Belgrade, Serbia, because that's where my mother and father met and married. And that's where I was conceived and almost born. So Belgrade was a very important place for me to visit. And so that was our first destination. We also in Serbia, before we left, because we started and ended our trip in Serbia, and we went to a little town called Zrenjanin, which was apparently in the 90s when there was the terrible war between Serbia and Croatia and all of those places. It was the only place not hit substantially and destroyed. It wasn't hit at all. It was like a miracle place. So it was wonderful to see some of these areas. I want you to know that every place we were visiting in Serbia and Croatia, these had ruins from pre-Roman as well as Roman times. So I was seeing amazing edifices. Some of those places, just to tell you, we went to, of course, the capital of Serbia, Belgrade, the capital of Croatia, was Zagreb, and also the largest city is Zagreb. But we visited places like Zadar, which had a sea organ, not to mention ruins, that were more spectacular and well-preserved than many of the ruins in Rome. So if you want to see some ruins, I saw ruins so much so that I finally got tired of ruins because they have so many. My entire trip was mostly along the Dalmatian coast because that's what Croatia covers mostly. So it was beautiful, beautiful, magnificent territory. On our return back, we went through Plitvice National Park, which is, it's visited by more than a million visitors every year. It has, how many lakes? 16 lakes that are arranged in cascades, not by nature. And so there are waterfalls everywhere. It was spectacular. I promise you, if you plan on traveling, you will learn so many more things that I could say in this short 5 to 7 minutes. Thank you.